Bring home a bucket full of flavor. 15 pieces of Kentucky Fried Chicken for just $6.89. Tuesdays and Wednesdays at Kentucky Fried Chicken. From Boca Raton to Jupiter, Lake Okeechobee, and the Glades.
Rudy's Air Conditioning. Rude
now offers a new central unit so energy efficient that we call it the Advantage. Rude makes it possible for Rude dealers to offer energy efficient air conditioning with a quality reputation. That's what my customers are looking for. Air conditioning with the Advantage in Palm Beach County.
Rude is air conditioning.
They walk, they talk. They can beat you. Boy, is this business changing. But people are changing too. They're smarter. They start out here in the Yellow Pages before they start out in their cars. That's why I took a bigger ad. So they'd see me, and so I could tell them more about my friends. It's just good business. People start out here. I stand out here.
Stand out where people start out when they're ready to buy. In the Southern Bell Yellow Pages.
Hello, I'm Max Robinson. When I was recently on the campus of the University of Florida, it was my pleasure to meet Andrea Pelt, a National Achievement Scholar. You can assure more students like Andrea coming to the University of Florida by contributing to scholarship funds. I'm making my contribution. Why don't you?
Channel 12, your station for news. This is Channel 12 News, the 6 o'clock report with Eleanor Schano-White.
Good evening, everyone. Water problems top the news tonight in Juneau Beach. That town is quickly running out of water. Officials say residents are using too much water on their lawns, in their swimming pools, and on other household luxuries. Well, tonight, the town council will hear a proposal from a consulting engineer on ways of solving the dilemma.
If they can cut their consumption in half, it would perhaps last them 4 to 6 weeks. If consumption remains at its present levels, I would guess that the time would be something less than half. Well, there hasn't been any significant rainfall since early February, and rainfall is the only source of water to recharge the aquifer from which they pump their public water supply. People to use more water when it doesn't rain, principally for irrigation, and of course, the question of it compounds itself.
Angel considers his plan a last-ditch effort. He says if the council doesn't pass the emergency measure, the water problem will continue to worsen. Meantime, a few miles to the north, water problems are also plaguing the city of Jupiter. As Robert Smith reports, various government and environmental agencies are locked in a battle over ways of improving the drinking supply.
Jupiter officials want to take more water out of the ground, and the South Florida Water Management District has okayed that plan. But that's going to throw a wrench into some other plans. The Loxahatchee River Environmental Control District had hoped the town's plan would be turned down, because if those wells are dug, they'll have to abandon plans to use water ponds to treat sewage.
Well, the ponds were constructed as part of the facility of the district. Originally, they were intended to be used for percolation. We will have to reconfigure the ponds and use them for a different purpose than intended.
We're lowering the water, ground level water out there, and they maintain that they cannot use their ponds, but they have never been permitted in the first place to use them ponds. By us lowering the water level, it doesn't completely prohibit them from using the ponds. They can line the ponds and go ahead and use them.
Officials from several environmental groups have looked at the town's plan and say they approve of it because it will not harm the ecology. And since almost everyone approves, town officials say they will start accepting bids to drill the wells tomorrow and expect it will cost at least $150,000. Robert Smith, 12 News, Jupiter.
Water shortages aren't limited to towns and cities tonight. Lake Okeechobee's water level is very low due to a lack of rain. Now a ban on commercial fishing on the lake has been imposed. Well, this is going to have a drastic effect on the industry, and John Matthews is standing by with a live report. John, a couple of questions. First of all, exactly how is this ban going to work, and how are the fishermen going to react to this?
First of all, Eleanor, they're not reacting happily to it. We're talking about several hundred fishermen who will be banned commercially from fishing on Lake Okeechobee beginning at sunset day after tomorrow, Friday night. With me is the Game and Freshwater Fish Commissioner, not the commissioner, but one of the officers, Biff Lampton. And Biff, we're talking about a major effect to not only people, but the cities, aren't we, around the lake?
That's right. The commercial fishing industry is worth approximately $8 million a year to the lake cities.
It's million, right?
Million.
Okay.
And we're looking at the heavy impact from that loss. Mm-hmm.
What has really happened is the lake has shrunk, has it not?
This is true. In the past 2 weeks, the lake level has dropped 5 inches, and within the next month, we anticipate it dropping another foot. And that crowds the fish out into the open water where they're more susceptible to commercial harvest methods. What we're trying to do is to prevent a possible overharvest and consequently problems with the sport fishing industry this winter.
Now, will the sports fishing industry actually be affected, or is it just the commercial industry?
The sports fishing industry will not be affected. There is no ban or restriction on sports fishing on the lake. It will be on commercial fishing.
So we're talking about 200 or 300 fishermen. They'll be put out of work. Did they have any forewarning that this problem was coming that way?
Yes, about a month ago we said that this might be a step that might be necessary depending on the water levels.
So they know about it. They prepared for it. Is there any chance they could get some state help like the Orange Grove farmers do when the winter weather hurts their...
There's always that possibility. They are independent businessmen with the other rights of Florida citizens.
Okay. So what happens if they don't go along with a ban? They say halfway through the situation, hey, I got to go pay my rent. I'm going to go out there and fish some fish. What happens to them?
We'll have to be looking closely at it from a law enforcement standpoint, and we will be monitoring it. We will have officers on the lake to prevent any problems.
They could be arrested?
They could be.
They could be thrown in jail?
They could be.
When is this ban going to be lifted?
It depends on the weather. Hopefully we'll get a lot of rain, the lake will come up, and everybody will be happy again.
Is this a normal thing that happens, you know, the water goes around, retreats every year, or is this something that happens once every 10 years, or what?
Florida experiences cycles in the water levels. The most recent was about 4 years ago, and this is what we're basing this closure on.
So they're used to it. Thanks, Biff.
Thank you.
Well, that's the way it goes. The water shortage problem, the lack of rain is hurting all of us. The fires that we've seen in Loxahatchee, the water shortage you mentioned a little while ago in Juneau and Jupiter, and of course down in Boca Raton, and now commercial fishing off Lake Okeechobee. And we'll have to just hope that we get some good rains this summer. John Matthews reporting live from the Game and Freshwater Fish Commission out by the airport. Back to you, Eleanor.
Okay, John, thank you. Related news tonight, Delray Beach fire officials say a water shortage is partly to blame for a morning brush fire. It took firefighters nearly 2 hours to bring the blaze under control, which burned 15 acres in the area of Germantown Road near Linton Boulevard. No one was hurt, no houses were damaged. That cause of that fire is still under investigation, but officials say the dry weather, the high winds are ideal conditions for brush fires. Well, coming up, Ma Bell wants more money. We'll have details when we return.
Beautiful music all the time. WEAT FM. Stereo 104.5.
Introducing the dawn of a new automobile dealership, the Exposition. Awakening Stewart, Jupiter, and the Palm Beaches to the ultimate driving machine. The BMW, the sporty 320i, the four-door 528i, the luxury 633 CSI Coupe, and 733i Sedan. All on display at the Exposition. The discriminating edge.
This is an elephant. Strong, reliable, and very impressive. This is a GE Central air conditioner. Also strong, reliable, and very impressive. And this is a technician from Personalized Air Conditioning. Very strong and reliable. Through May 1st, you can receive a $150 refund on the purchase of a GE Executive 2 Central Air Conditioner. For very impressive service, call PAC, your GE Central Air Conditioning representative, Boca Raton and Vero Beach.
Mr. Howie wants to be a do-it-yourselfer, but he's not sure how. He came to Century Hardware for expert advice and quality name brand products like Nelson Sprinklers Dial 5 or Oscillating Your Choice 477. A reliable entry lock set from Quickset 848.
Thank you, Century.
Century Hardware. We're ready to help when you're ready to do it yourself.
Southern Bell's proposed increase in its telephone rates and charges has caused some confusion among many customers, but as Doreen Marcial reports, those concerned will get a chance tomorrow to air their feelings.
The fourth of a series of public hearings scheduled by Florida's Public Service Commission will take place tomorrow in West Palm Beach. The proposed increases would affect a number of services, such as installation and private line rates, but the biggest concern among consumer advocates is the local measured service plan. Basically, the plan would limit the number of local calls and the length, but the monthly charge would be reduced. One Southern Bell spokesperson notes that this service would be optional. However, to make an unlimited amount of phone calls, your monthly rate would be higher. So far, there has been strong opposition.
It's a scheme to increase revenues. It is going to hurt broad-based citizen challenge of rate hikes, which is what's going on right here. It is a question of invading privacy. There are no kinds of safeguards to protect a person being placed on hold.
Clark says these things and other issues need to be addressed. Meanwhile, the phone company gives this rationale.
A new philosophy that we're trying to adopt is that the cost causer should pay the cost. There are many, many telephone users out there that are low use type telephone people. They don't make that many calls. And an option will be available for them to provide an economic choice.
Tomorrow, Florida's Public Service Commission will get a chance to hear exactly how Southern Bell customers feel, whether they believe it's designed to help them control their bills, or is it a scheme for the phone company to make more money? Doreen Marcial, 12 News, West Palm Beach.
A new county ordinance regulating the selling of secondhand gold and silver went into effect today. The ordinance requires dealers to register all the jewelry they buy with the Sheriff's Department. Dave Wirth reports on some lingering opposition.
The purpose of the ordinance is to recover some of the stolen gold and silver that might pass through these secondhand jewelry shops. Some dealers like the ordinance, some don't.
I'm in favor of it. In a way, it'll slow down a little bit on the amount of ease it is for people to sell gold and silver rapidly. Now we have to get lots of identification, an accurate description of the article that we're purchasing, the price that we're paying for the piece, and also their thumbprint.
Only a fool would bring his merchandise to me or to anybody else. It's going to drive it underground. There's not going to be any recovery of stolen merchandise. If you had stricter licensing of who's allowed to be in this business and who's not allowed to be in this business, if you put an end to transient buyers in motels and in flea markets, I think you'd go a lot further to solving the problem of an easy disposal of stolen merchandise.
Dealers like these must perform three tasks to comply with the ordinance. First, they must photograph the seller or his driver's license or fingerprint him. Second, they must write a report on the purchase and deliver it to the sheriff on a daily basis. And third, they must hold on to the merchandise for 7 days. The detractors say this will only force criminals to go underground with the stolen goods. Dave Wirth, 12 News in Palm Beach County.
Tonight, the County Health Department is concerned over an alarming increase in the most common form of venereal disease. Reported cases of gonorrhea in Palm Beach County rose by 16% last year. Now, women seem to be afflicted more than men and are also susceptible to a serious complication, pelvic inflammatory disease, or PID.
It's estimated that 10 to 17% of all women with gonorrhea will develop pelvic inflammatory disease. These figures seem to hold true in both the local and state levels. Last year, 10% of the women with gonorrhea in the state of Florida was diagnosed with gonococcal PID.
15% of the women affected by PID become sterile. Now the Department of Health and Rehabilitative Services has begun a public awareness program. In other news, Palm Beach County judges began using a new system of sentencing criminals today. Stan Zimmerman reports the experiment is not without controversy.
This is a plea conference between a judge, a prosecutor, and a defense attorney. And here they may agree on punishment, the sentence of the court. The range of that punishment, for instance, 5 years to life, is set by law, but the exact sentence is up to the discretion of the judge. A new experiment will change all this slightly, because Palm Beach County judges will now use guidelines, a kind of point system, which the state Supreme Court hopes will provide more even sentences for similar crimes.
Everybody thinks guidelines is going to change everything, okay? I don't believe it is. It's going to put sentencing in the sunshine. So what was in the computer before is going to be, you know, available to people in writing. and it's hopefully going to create a more normative sentencing.
Judge Mounts was part of a statewide panel which drafted the guidelines, but not everybody in the criminal justice system thinks they're a good idea.
At the outset, we have the reservations about equal protection of law. We have the reservations about the sentences being, if they're inside the matrix, being not sufficient sentences for the crime.
So many points, so many years. That's the heart of the guideline system, but judges can still violate it if they see fit.
We still have discretion. We still have the power and the duty to recognize mitigating and aggravating circumstances and to go outside of the guidelines, and I intend to do it.
The experiment lasts for 1 year, was ordered in four judicial circuits, including Palm Beach County, and Judge Mounts is excited about it.
Here we are involved in a really fresh and invigorating experiment, and I just think it's outstanding, and I'm really glad Palm Beach County got a chance to be included.
Stan Zimmerman, 12 News, the Palm Beach County Courthouse.
Still ahead, a new twist to a very old tradition.
Pick it up. Do you hear it? Pick it up.
When you need to rock and roll, listen to the only real rock and roll station, 99IZD. For over 50 years, First National Bank in Palm Beach has been building toward the 1980s, the most dynamic years for Palm Beach County. Now we're ready, with international services not found just anywhere. Services such as foreign currency, overseas transfers, and direct correspondence in many countries. If your needs are international, First National Bank in Palm Beach is ready. We're building our international capabilities every day for your banking convenience.
Grand opening. Beds, beds, beds at huge discounts now. It's Beds and Spreads for the largest selection of Serta bedding in the state of Florida. Serta, maker of the perfect sleeper. You'll never buy for less. Free frame or pillow with every bed purchase, plus free delivery and setup. Hurry in today and save like never before. Beds and Spreads on Military Trail, just south of Okeechobee Boulevard, across from Alpacker Ford. Remember, when you think of a new bed or spread, think of Beds and Spreads. Famous Serta bedding at discount prices.
You can find your dream come true, a home that's built just for you. Flowers and trees at your front door, it's everything and even more. Live and play at your own pace, it's right for you, your kind of place. It's your kind of place, Wellington.
Easter came early today for a very special group of young people at Dreher Park. It came in the form of beeping Easter eggs. These eggs were placed on the lawn for blind and handicapped children so they too could enjoy an Easter egg hunt. They may look like they're from the space age, but actually this isn't a totally new concept.
Inspired last year with our council with the fact that the telephone company employees have put together what they call a beeper ball, which has blind children actually playing softball. So last year they thought of this idea, well, we have a beeper ball for softball, why not a beeper type egg for an Easter egg hunt for blind children?
The second annual egg hunt was set up by the Council of Telephone Pioneers of America. Patty, what a nice idea,
wasn't
it though?
Yeah.
Well, that brings to mind that Easter is just around the corner, so people want nice, warm weather, no rain, and yet we have a serious water shortage here in the area. What's the forecast?
Right. Well, we will have Easter Florida style. It will be sunny, and we have a frontal system coming, which usually brings rain, but this time of year we're not getting the rains, we're getting the winds instead. So that's unfortunate for us. It's going to start getting much windier tomorrow, but right now outside it's been a beautiful day and our temperature is still warm. 78 degrees, humidity 62%. The winds are starting to increase out of the east-northeast at 20 miles an hour. Barometric pressure 30.28 and holding steady, and the surf temperature is nice and warm at 75 degrees. Low last night was 69, high temperature today 82. No rainfall, and the air quality is 26 in the good range. In fact, we've had no significant rainfall for the entire month of April. Now, there is a weather producer that is causing some rain. Most of it is over Texas. The frontal system now stretches across the Gulf of Mexico into northern Florida. The rain is spreading into the northern part of the state, but it will dissipate by the time it reaches here in South Florida. In the east, most of the showers have pushed offshore, and there were really clear skies over much of the nation, except as you saw over the southern plains and also out in the Pacific Northwest. The heaviest rains today came from western Texas, about 6 inches reported in the Rio Grande Valley, 1 to 2 inches common from Texas on up into Colorado and Kansas. Lots of sunshine over the eastern United States, and some record highs reported before the frontal system passed through northern Florida. It was 85 in Pensacola and 91 in both Tallahassee and Fort Myers, and those were record highs. Some heavy thunderstorms starting to develop in the north central area of Florida. Meanwhile, the showers have pushed off the east coast. There's very cool and windy conditions moving in from the mid-Atlantic coast state northward. They may have some freezing and frost warnings out tonight for the mid-Atlantic coast area. Now we'll check the afternoon temperatures from around the country. Heavy thunderstorms starting to develop around the Ocala area. Some small tornadoes were sighted there. No reports of any damages or injuries. And there is a severe thunderstorm warning for the area north of Tampa Bay, Florida. But we're going to have nice, fair skies over South Florida in spite of the fact that the frontal system will be passing through tomorrow. And so for tonight's forecast, we're calling for partly cloudy weather and a 20% chance of showers. Maybe we'll get a few sprinkles out of it. Northeasterly winds 10 to 15 miles an hour. And the lows tonight, mid-60s inland and near 70 along the coast. Sunny but very windy tomorrow. Northeasterly winds at about 20 to 25 miles an hour and highs in the upper 70s to low 80s. And for boaters, a small craft advisory has been placed in effect. Northeasterly winds at 20 knots. Seas increasing 5 to 8 feet and inland coastal waters becoming choppy to rough. And there's the tide information for you. Sunset at 6:44 tonight and sunrises tomorrow at 5:56 in the morning. So we have more winds. That's springtime in Florida, windy weather.
Well, I guess, Patty, until you can come up with some rain, we're just going to have to all conserve water best we can.
That's right.
Thanks, Patty. Jim Gallagher is along next with all the sports when 12 News continues.
They're rolling in. These are the automobiles Stuart Pontiac bought last year before the price increases. And these beautiful 81s can be yours for way less than list price. This Grand Prix, loaded with luxury extras, lists at $94.15. You can buy for $73.89. You save over $2,000. Firebirds, Bonnevilles, Phoenix, and Le Mans, now at special savings. Come in today.
I really enjoy my pool, and I know it's clean because I use Sentry Pool Sanitizer to control bacteria and algae. It's the only kind I use. It's the only kind I sell. I'm a pool care specialist. Giving you good advice about your pool is my job. Sentry is sold only by pool specialists, not at supermarkets or five and dimes. See them for peas and nail polish. See me for pool care. Sentry Pool Sanitizer, available only at pool care specialists.
Lately, a lot of people are jogging. Jogging is great for your legs, but it doesn't do much for your upper body.
I'm Bill McArdle.
I'm John Magel.
We're exercise physiologists, and we've designed a new fitness program for European health spas called PACE.
PACE is an aerobic workout for your whole body in just 30 minutes.
So if you're looking for a fast, efficient way to get in shape,
try PACE at European health spas. It's a more complete workout than jogging, and you don't have to go out for a shower.
A celebration is a special time to share with family and friends. What better way to celebrate than with good food from Pantry Pride? Fresh fruits and vegetables that look good and taste good. Dairy and bakery products that are guaranteed fresh. And topped off with a self-basting farmer-grade turkey that tastes so good, you'll go back for more. A farmer-grade turkey will bring out the smiles and make your celebration special. Good things from the pantry to your table. You can count on Pantry Pride.
Well, tonight's the night. The night to get your check in the mail to Uncle Sam. Midnight is the deadline for filing your income tax return from last year. West Palm Beach Post Office downtown will be open and staffed to handle the last-minute rush. Because of the heavy volume, if you're expecting a refund, you might have to wait 3 months. If you need an extension on your filing, well, you can check with the IRS at the federal building. And if you're headed for the post office tonight, you just might run into South Florida's number one sportscaster. Is that what you're going to do between shows?
No, believe it or not, I got it done early. I got it done this afternoon. No, I was ahead of time.
Retirement, Eleanor, is breaking up that old Dolphin gang. Tim Foley, the veteran All-Pro safety, is retiring from pro football due to a knee problem. Foley was a mainstay for Miami in their Super Bowl years, but missed most of last season and all of 1979. Just 2 months ago, Larry Little, another All-Pro performer at guard, announced that he was stepping out. And there also is word that the architect of Miami's great offense of the early 70s, quarterback Bob Greasy, may also join Little and former Purdue teammate Foley on the sidelines. Greasy was injured for the last part of 80, and his shoes were more than ably filled by young Dave Woodley. Two NBA playoffs can end tonight. The Kansas City Kings will visit Phoenix with a 3-1 lead in their best-of-7 series, and Houston will be hosting San Antonio. The Rockets right now have a 3-2 lead, so they could put San Antonio out with a win tonight. Milwaukee will visit Philadelphia. That series is tied at 2 apiece. No action this evening in the National Hockey League Stanley Cup playoffs, but last night Philadelphia and St. Louis both were winners, so they'll advance. Main Event Sports Productions is going to make another try at promoting a successful boxing program at the West Palm Beach Auditorium next Wednesday night. Tony Chiaverini of Kansas City, a middleweight shown here on the right in the light trunks, will headline the card in a 10-round main go, and he will be meeting Frank Medina. Chiaverini, now middleweight, once fought Sugar Ray Leonard for the welterweight crown and lost. The Kansas City fighter is 38-6-2 with 25 knockouts. He is ranked 10th in the world by the WBC. Jeff Sims, the Belgrade fighter, who is now 13-1 as a heavy, will be meeting Leon Shaw for the Florida heavyweight title. The West Palm Beach Expos are on the road again. Tonight they'll face Tampa at Al Lopez Field on the West Coast. Last night they lost to Twin Bill at St. Petersburg. And there was some action this afternoon in the major leagues, 2 in the American and 2 in the National. In the American, Chicago over Milwaukee 5-4. And Hoyt, the winner, he is now 2-0 for the Chi Sox. Yastrzemski drove in 3 runs during the afternoon as Boston topped the Baltimore O's by a score of 7-2. In the National League, Peck Zachary the winner as the Mets defeated the Cardinals 5-3. Zachary's now 2-0, and the Expos beat the Cubs this afternoon 5-4. Fernando Valenzuela of the Dodgers is this week's National League Player of the Year. He is a 20-year-old left-hander and got a surprise start on the opening day against the tough Houston Astros. Came through with a 5-hit shutout, striking out 5, so he is the Player of the Week in the National League. Little number 34. Looks like a little tugboat.
Sure does.
But he throws like a bullet. That's
okay, for Jim. When we return, we're going to take a look at some very talented ladies.
There ought to be a limit on how low a guy can get. This guy, Steve Moore, he's not stopping yet. He's driving other dealers crazy and people ought to know. He sells his cars and trucks to dad blame low. These other dealers, they're just trying to make a buck. But with Steve Moore around, they're really out of luck. There's something about this Steve Moore I'd really like to know. How does he sell his cars and trucks so dad blame low?
The first American Revolution can free you from the tyranny of checking account hassle. Free checking at First American Bank means free personal checking with no bothersome service charges, and free checks printed with your name and address are yours absolutely free. Just look at your present account to see what it's costing you elsewhere. Then join the First American Revolution by opening a free checking account at any of our 11 convenient offices. First American Bank, the home of free checking.
Announcing the floor sample sale at Springer's Furniture Center. Every individual piece of furniture and every grouping is available. Thousands of items, $1 million worth of floor samples. See living rooms, bedrooms, dining rooms, and accessories. Save up to 50% on furniture, accessories, and original works of art. Springer's floor sample sale is very special. Don't miss this chance to save on quality furniture at Springer's Furniture Center, 4000 South Federal Highway, Fort Pierce.
Hi, I'm Jeff Marcus, and I've made a fantastic buy on 1-carat diamonds, only $2,799. Regular $5,000, now 1-carat fine quality diamond engagement rings or pendants, only $2,799 at Marcus Jewelers. The supply of these high clarity 1-carat diamonds is limited. So for the 1-carat diamond buy of the year at only $2,799, it's Marcus Jewelers Cross County Mall. And I'm Jeff Marcus, your friend in the diamond and jewelry business.
What do you get when you take 75 local women, give them some costumes, let them sing, and enter them in a statewide contest? Well, you get the area chapter of the Sweet Adelines, an entertaining group which travels around the county, bringing a lot of joy into people's lives. Recently, the ladies won a state contest in Orlando as the best group in the region. They'll now go to Georgia and Alabama to compete in the international event next year. Believe me, gals can really pour it on. Listen. The Sweet Adelines of Palm Beach County, a fun group and a fine group of people. Well, that's the early edition of 12 News. John Matthews will be back tonight at 11. ABC World News Tonight is next with more on the latest development concerning the space shuttle. I'm Eleanor Schano-White. Thanks for joining us and have a nice evening, everyone. Born on the wind, naked in mind. Night fever, night fever. We know how to do it, do it, do it.
Don't just sit there. Come on and play.
There are millions of prizes to win in McDonald's $10 million Build-A-Big Mac game.
The Mercedes-Benz, one of the finest motor cars in the world, has exceptional comfort, style, and class. The BMW, one of the finest motor cars in the world, has exceptional comfort, style, and class. The Audi 5000, one of the finest motor cars in the world.